Peace be upon you, dear first year students of the Morning Studies and English Department. I'm talking to you about our topic for this lecture, which is the present perfect tense. I mentioned in the previous lectures and the last lectures what is meant by tense, the present simple tense, the past tense, present continuous, past continuous. Then we move to the present perfect tense. Okay, before indulging in explaining what is meant by the present perfect continuous tense, I want to clarify what is meant by the perfective aspect. Some claim that the perfective aspect signifies past time with what? With a current relevance. And some regard it this description isn't an adequate description of the meaning of the perfective aspect. So let us take the following examples, okay, to clarify this point. John lived, for example, we have John lived in Paris for 10 years. Here we have simple past. Or past simple. John has lived in Paris for 10 years, present perfect. Here we have both sentences indicate a state of affairs before the present moment, but the simple past indicates that the period of residence has come to a close. Okay, so in the first one, the period of residence has came to a close. He lived in Paris, but no more now. In the past, he lived in Paris, but now, okay, he lives in another place. This is the point. But when John has lived in Paris for 10 years, present perfect, here we have he has lived in Paris in the past and up to the present moment. This is the point. Now we have the present perfect refers to an event or state that either happened at an indefinite time in the past. For example, we have met before. Here we have the example, we have met before. We refer to what? An event, okay? That happened in the past or started in the past and continued, or we have what? The event started in the past and continued up to the present time. Example, John has... But we have grown impatient over the last hour. So we have John has grown impatient over the last hour. Here we have something that started in the past. Okay, the growing of impatient. It started in the past and is continued up to the present time. Let us move to the form of what the present perfect. Form we have has, have, plus past participle. As you know that we have had the choice of has or have depends on what? On the form of the verb, okay? I, we, you, take, have, but has, he, she, and it. The first element is have or has depending on the subject, the verb conjugated with. The second element is the past participle, which is usually, okay, we have two types of the past participle formed. We add ed or d to the d to the base form of the verb, such as we have worked, played, cleaned, washed, and etc. Or we have what regular past participle, such as we have done, said, gone, known, own, and etc. These examples show what how the present perfect can describe something that occurred or was the state of thing at an unspecified time in the past. So it refers to an unspecified time in the past. Okay. This is the point. The present perfect continuous. This tense is used to what? To describe what? To describe an activity that has recently stopped or just stopped. So either the activity that has recently stopped or what we call it just stopped. So we have what example, John is very tired. He has been working very hard. So when we say that John is very tired, he has been working very hard. This refers to that. This means that he is tired now. So the thing, the present perfect tense is related with now, because we see him very tired. He has been working very hard. This is the point. Where have you been? I have been looking for you. Everywhere. So this is the point here we have. Where have you been? I have been looking for you everywhere. I have just what found you. This is the point we have. What? Something that started in the past that it is related with now. And now I'm looking for you. The other example we have, you are out of breath. Have you been running? In the following example we have, you have you been what running? You are what? How will we call it? You are out of breath now. So because you are out of breath now, we regard that he has been running. Okay, this is the point. Example we have, it has been raining for 2 hours. Let us move to the other example. It has been raining for 2 hours. This means that when we say for 2 hours, this means that it began raining 2 hours ago. Okay, then, and it is still raining. So it started raining before 2 hours ago and it is still raining. If we want to ask about something in the present continuous, perfect continuous tense, we make use of how long. How long has it been raining? It has been raining for 2 hours. So put in your mind that how long is used with what? With the present perfect continuous. The present perfect continuous is used with how long and since. Okay, so it refers to an activity that is still happening or has just stopped. So if the activity that is still happening or just stopped, how it's still happening. For example, we have it has been raining for 2 hours. So in the past, in the for 2 hours, it started raining 2 hours ago and it is still water raining. It has been raining. This is the point. How long have you been learning English? This means that what? You are still learning English. You started learning English in the past and you are still learning English at the present moment. So this is the point. Then we have what? A description about how long. Okay, if you want to ask how long have you been, so we use what? If you want to ask about period of something, we use what? How long? How? As it is clarified in unit 11, how long have you been? Then let us take an example. Dan and Jenny are married. They got married exactly 20 years ago. So today is their 20th wedding anniversary. Okay, they have been married for 20 years. We say they are married present. So if we say that they are married, it is a present simple. But how long have they been married? Present perfect. Not how long are they married. No, they have been married for 20 years. Not they are married for 20 years. If we talk about they are why married for 20 years, it is what? In the present time. But they have been married for 20 years. Okay, they married before about 20 years and up to this moment. Okay, we can use the present perfect to talk about again something that began in the past and it is and still continues now. So let us take an example. Paul is in hospital. He has been in hospital since Monday. He has been, not Paul is in hospital since Monday. Okay, this is the point. Do you know each other well? Have you known each other for a long time? Not do you know. So we have what, how long. If we want to ask about something, we use how long. She is waiting for somebody. She has been waiting all morning. Do they have a car? How long have they had their car? This is the point. Okay, so we have what? How long is used with what? With the present perfect continuous. We talked about the actions, that is what, the sins and fors, for sins, for when and how long. We use for and since where We have what? Unit 12. To say that how long something has been happening, we use for plus a period of time. 2 hours, 6 weeks, etc. Look at the following examples. I have been waiting for 2 hours. For two hours ago. From 2 hours ago up to now, okay? So I have been waiting 2 hours ago in the past, and I'm still waiting up to the present moment, up to now. Look, 2 hours is used with what? With 4, 20 minutes, 5 days, 6 months, okay, a long time, a week, days, years, 50 years, 5 days. This is the point. So let us move to since. We use since as plus the start of a period. 8 o'clock, Monday, okay, 1990. Now we have 1999. I have been waiting since 8 o'clock. So we use since plus what? The start of the period. From this period, we start up to the coming time. But now we start, but in 4, we start from something in the past. Okay, for 2 hours, I was waiting you 2 hours up to now. But and since what we have the time and up to now. This is the point. 8 o'clock now. 8 o'clock April, lunchtime. So, since 8 o'clock, since April, since lunchtime, since Monday. Okay, we arrived on 12th of May, Christmas. I got up. This is the point. Sally has been working here for 6 months. Not since 6 months. Why? Because we use for to talk about something started from the time. 6 months up to the following time months. But Sally has been working here since April. So since April up to from April until now. This is the point. I haven't seen Tom for 3 days. I haven't seen Tom since Monday. This is the point. So here we have a difference between for and since, as it is clarified. We have what in unit 13, present perfect and past. Look, I have done and I did, as we talked about in the last lecture about the past tense present. The past simple tense is used to indicate to something an event or a state that happened in the past and stopped, okay? There is what? A period of time between the past and now. Look, Tom is looking for his key. He can't find it. He has lost his key. Present perfect, he has lost. This means that he doesn't have his key. 10 minutes later, after 10 minutes, we have what? Now, Tom has found his key. He has it now. Has he lost his key? No, he hasn't found it. Did he lose his key? Yes, he did. He lost his key. Past participle. But now he has found it. We have what? Present perfect. So, the present perfect, something has happened, is a present tense. It always tells us about a situation now. So, Tom has lost his key. He doesn't have his key now. As we mentioned that if he has lost it, he doesn't find his key now at the present time. The past simple, something happened in the past, tells us only about the past. I mean, as I mentioned, there should be what? A gap or a period of time between the past and the present. Now, if somebody says Tom lost his key, this does not tell us whether he has the key now or not. If he lost it in the past, it tells us only that he lost key at some time in the past. So here we have what it tells us about something, an action or event or state in the past. Don't use the present perfect if the situation now is different compared. They have gone away. They will be back on Friday. They are away now. They went away, but I think they are back at home now. Not they have gone. It has been stopped raining, okay? So we don't need the umbrella. It isn't raining now. It stopped raining for a while, but now it is raining again. Not it has stopped. You can use the present perfect too for new or recent happenings. I have repaired this washing machine. It is working okay now. Oh, that is good. Sally has had a baby. It is a boy. That is great news. Okay. So you can use the past simple. For example, we have I repaired the washing machine. It is working okay now. In the past, I repaired it, but as a result, it is working in the present moment. Okay. We use the past simple, not the present perfect, for things that are not recent or new. Mozart was a composer. He wrote more than 600 pieces of music. Not has been or has written. Why? Because Mozart something from the past. My mother grew up in Italy. Not has grown. Okay, because she grew up there. Not now. So we have what, as I mentioned previously, there is what present, the past simple and the present perfect. They aren't interchangeable. Okay. Did you know that somebody has invented a new type of washing machine? Who invented the telephone? Not has invented, okay? Because invention of machine of telephone is something from the past. Here we have just a comparison between present perfect and past perfect and past tense. I have done and I did in unit 14. Don't use the present perfect I have done when you talk about a finished time. As we mentioned that if you talk about a completed action or a finished time in the past, we use the past tense, not the present perfect. Okay. Okay. Or example, we have what yesterday, 10 minutes ago in 2005, when I was a child, we use the past tense to talk about something in the past. It was very cold yesterday, not has been. Paul and Lucy, a further example. Paul and Lucy arrived 10 minutes ago, not have arrived. Did you eat a lot of sweets when you were a child? Not have you eaten? I got home late last night. I was very tired and I went straight to bed. Use the past, this is another note, use the past tense to ask what, when, or what time. For example, we have, when did your friends arrive, not have arrived, what time did you finish work, okay? That is all we have in this lecture. Thank you. Goodbye.